Ooh, nice little Britney-ism.
Oh, yeah. Oh, baby. Oh.
Here we go. Here we go. My name is Barrett. I am a record producer. And today we're going to listen to the new single from Britney Spears and Elton John. I've been following the Britney story, and I think it's fucked up what they did to her and what happened. And I think she deserves all the success she can get after the torture and mayhem that they've caused her by her family. I mean, they started really early with she started the Mouseketeers as a child. I haven't really listened to this. I don't know what it's about. I'm hoping it's good. Tell me what you guys think down in the comments. We can check it out. And please subscribe and come back and say hello. And I appreciate it. I appreciate you coming. Hold me closer, Tiny Dancer. This was a great song when it came out. I did read a little bit of something about it before, saying that they used a guitar track from the original song and slowed it down, and Elton's voice is slowed down and from the original song. I don't know. It sounds computerized. Let's check it out. So it really sounds like that Hold Me Closer thing is sampled, literally sampled, and played on a keyboard. Because it's like changing keys, but it's the same part. All right, so this song's definitely meant for the dance floor. It's got the really heavy low bass going on and the funky beat. This is a remix meant for the dance floor. I mean, it's cool. They really have gone heavy on the autotune to the point where it might even be played with a keyboard. Kind of like the original autotune Cher effect from Cher's song, If You Believe in Life After Love. If you all remember that little ditty that started off the whole thing of autotune as an effect, not just a tune, because Cher could sing. I know that Britney can sing. I certainly know Elton John can sing. So this is tuning as an effect, which is kind of cool for people who are fucked up and dancing on a dance floor. Count the headlights on the highway. I'm mesmerized by this visual of a toy rocket ship spewing out rose petals. There are caravans we follow. So that must be the slowed down Elton voice. It's weird. Britney-ism. Britney got a lot of that stuff from Michael Jackson back in the day, I think. She learned how to do the,
oh yeah, oh baby. Oh.
When chances breathe between the stars. When sex and love no longer jam.
See, I think they're messing up. They're messing with his voice too much. I mean, I really feel like this whole project probably got taken over by whoever the producer was on it. And just, he just, he's a dance. I don't know. I should know. I should have looked it up. I do know that Britney went to his house to record, but I don't think Elton had that much to do with this production. I would be interested to know who played bass, because it's a cool bass line. I'm not 100% sure it's a real bass or a synth bass. It could easily be either. I think it might be a real bass, but I'm not sure. There's not a lot going on here in this song. I mean, you've had a few little interludes of verse things, but it's mostly just this chorus, a vamp on Hold Me Closer. Lots of like kicking into the dance part and then dropping out to the ethereal. Hold me closer, hold me closer. Here's some more Britney-isms. Nice Britney. Hold me closer. It's a nice little piano part. That chord right there, so 70s. You know, for what that's supposed to be, a dance song for clubs, it's good. And it's got all the things you need for that. So good on ya. I'm psyched about it, for both Britney and for Elton John. Great. Let me know what you guys think down in the comments. And please come back and say hello and subscribe. And thank you. Until next time.